We were talking about marriage classes and what they discussed with you during the marriage classes.
Told us not to get married because of being a Marine. It's really hard on the wife, and it's hard on the husband. But it's less hard on him than it is her. But they tell us what kind of programs they offer as far as money goes. Like if you're married, they'll automatically give you $800 a month for housing, plus $200 to $300 a month for food, and they give you $250 annually for clothes.
But if you're not married, then what, do you just stay in their housing?
Yeah, you just live. It's like having a roommate.
So it's free.
It's still free. Everything's free, and you just. Yeah, all your money goes right into the bank. I mean, you really don't need to pay for anything. They'll take care of everything.
So really, being single is the way to go.
Well, you would say that, but I wouldn't. I mean, I'm the kind of person that wants a family, and I'm not going to wait 5 years of active duty to have a family, to get married or have a family. I'm not waiting all those years. I can have a house on base and get an extra $1,000 a month, and you don't even have to pay for that house. If I got a house on base, there is no rent, there's no utilities, none of that stuff. No gas, I don't have to pay for anything like that. All I have to pay for is if I have a vehicle, I gotta pay for that, I gotta pay for nothing, that's it. If I have a vehicle, I pay for the vehicle. If I have a cell phone, I pay for the cell phone. Clothes, that's it. Any junk food purchases, stuff like that, I have to pay for out of my own pocket, but that's a wife that makes money, husband that makes money, and you really don't have to use any of that money, so it's all being banked.
Alright.
Well, it's a really good deal, I think.
Let's talk about the crucible now. Day one, this says you got up at 2 o'clock in the morning.
1:45.
Mm-hmm. And what, you got your stuff ready to go?
We already had everything ready to go.
Okay.
We put our packs on and we left.
So you didn't eat breakfast?
Yeah, we ate breakfast. We went to the chow hall. No, we did not. We did not eat breakfast. We did not eat breakfast.
Because this says you got up at 2, and then at 3, you walked 6 miles to the site.
Yep.
So yeah. What this says is all...
At 2, we were up and ready to go. At 3 o'clock, we started, and we were up and we were heading towards the site.
And was 6 miles, was that hard?
It was rough. It was, you couldn't see where you were going. You're carrying all that weight. By the time you get there, you're ready to drop it. Then you got to pick the packs up again and walk like 3 more miles because you're going. Because the first thing we had to do was a rifle range, and we were 3 miles off from the rifle range. So that's 9 miles in the first 3 hours.
So do you think, is it hard because it was at night? Would those miles have been that hard if it was daylight?
Probably.
So it was just hard walking 6 miles, period.
Yeah, with all that weight, with the pack. Without the pack, it'd been even.
So right.
You're going really fast.
Oh, you're going fast?
Yeah, I'm short. So it's rough for me.
Why would that make it rough?
Because they inverted the platoon, which means all the tall people are in the back and the short people are up front, so that the tall people don't leave us walking, you know?
Right.
And then, but you've got a couple guys up front that are short that just don't have, they're really slow, so they'll start walking slow. They'll get a huge distance between them and the person in front of them. They have to run to catch up to the person in front of them.
If we don't have the chair there for now on, he won't be able to get up there because he can't jump that high.
But they have to run to catch up to the person in front of him, which does what? Makes everybody in that whole line have to run to catch up. So you got to run. There's like short bursts of running through the entire thing. And it's just horrible. And your feet are already hurting. But the crucible, there's not really much to talk about. All you have to do is say, there's just crawling and scraping your knees and scraping your elbows and tons of crawling and getting up and getting down and getting up and getting down and crawling through sand and crawling through rocks and just putting you in, that we really didn't do battle scenarios, you don't really do things like that, you just...
Did anyone make it the entire time who did not make it through the Crucible?
Everybody made it through the Crucible.
That's good.
We actually had a guy that was on crutches the day before. Told the doctors he was fine, he had a hip problem, and he still made it.
You know, I remember there being somebody in the, on the website that was worried about their... I don't know if it was a son. I think it was a mother worried about her son because he was on crutches. So,
but yeah, everybody made it. Everybody.
So when you, that hike back, was it just as hard as the hike there, or was it worse because you were tired?
The first 3 miles, then we had a break. And my pack, it's supposed to sit on your hips. All the weight's supposed to be on your hips. And all mine was on my shoulders. And it was horrible. And then I tried to adjust it after the first 3 miles, and it didn't work. So I had to go 3 more miles on like painful shoulders. But then the last, it was like 4-3, whatever it makes up to like 9.5 miles. And the last, it was like 2 miles. That was the last one. It was 2 miles. We were getting back into town, and my feet were just killing. I could hardly walk. I was limping. I was my shoulders were killing me from the pack. Everything just seemed to the whole world seemed like it was in slow motion.
On Family Day, I know I'm jumping, but I know we don't have much battery power left. On Family Day,
6 minutes.
On Family Day, you did not get to do the motivational run. Did that disappoint you?
Not really.
No?
Nope, because I didn't feel like running anyway. Because it was going to be like, it was going to be, we had looked at it, and it was going to be, because the construction, it was only going to be 1.5 miles, but at a very slow pace, which would have been a piece of cake. But it was too cold, and it was raining,
yes.
And I really, really did not feel like doing that.
Okay, what was the worst part quickly? What was the worst part about the whole thing?
Crucible.
Okay, what was the thing you missed the most, besides a person?
What do I miss the most about it?
What was the thing while you were gone from home that you missed the most, and it can't be a person?
So it can't be family interaction?
No, it can't be anything, it just something you missed. Television, sleeping in, something to
eat. Sleeping in's a given. Food's a given because you're missing all the pop you used to drink, the candy, the chocolate that you don't even know what chocolate is anymore. All that's a given. Things for me that other people wouldn't have probably is piano, games, being able to, you know, seeing games that were coming out that I usually would save up and buy, I can't buy.
Is there anything that you're going to miss about being there?
No.
Not one thing?
No.
You won't miss sleeping in a... Were you afraid when you were on that top bunk?
Nope.
Were you afraid that you would fall off at any time? Why?
Because I couldn't have.
Why?
Sheets were too tight. If I had rolled, I would have got caught.
I was going to say, were the rails hidden somewhere?
No, I would have... No, that you don't fall off. When you're on a top rack, and see, I move a lot during sleep, but your mind knows where you are.
Did anybody ever fall off?
No. Nobody fell off.
Did you get to pick the top, or did they pick it for you?
You get to pick.
And you picked the top?
Mm-hmm.
And what was your reasoning?
Well,
or was there any?
One, I don't want to be looking up. I'd rather look at the ceiling and be able to look around the room and see everything than have to look at bars above my head, you know? Oh, I'm in jail.
Well, there it is. That's Parris Island. That's all my questions.